2249 First Street, Westfield. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner by beautiful Lake Erie in a summer cottage atmosphere with local wines and beers available. Support for Chautauqua Sunrise has been provided by WRFA, 107.9 FM, Jamestown's public radio station, streaming online 24/7 at WRFALP.com. Low power to the people. Bella Salon and Day Spa, located at 41 West Main Street in Northeast Pennsylvania, proudly supports Chautauqua Sunrise and its volunteers. More information at bellasalonanddayspa.net. Funding is provided by a grant from New York State Senator Catherine M. Young, representing Western New York's 57th District with a local office in Olean. Chautauqua Sunrise is made possible by a grant from Fredonia Place, a continuing care retirement community providing dignity in a modern luxury environment. From the Access Channel 5 studios in Mayville, it's Chautauqua Sunrise. Chautauqua Sunrise is hosted by Doc Hamels and supported by the award-winning volunteers at Access Channel 5. Continuing the traditions of Senior Report, we are here to share local news, colorful interviews, and events of interest to everyone. Chautauqua Sunrise is broadcast live Saturday mornings each week, countywide, from 9 to 10 a.m. Join us by calling in live, emailing us, or checking out our social media. And now, from the Channel 5 studios, it's Chautauqua Sunrise.
Hey everybody, welcome to Chautauqua Sunrise. I'm Doc Hamels and I'm back fresh from Europe, and I'm so glad to be back here. Had a great time there, and we'll talk a little bit about that in a while. But I want to welcome you to the show. If it's your first time with us, we got a great show lined up for you. In fact, this week and next week, I would say they're both kind of like to your health. Kind of one of those things where I think you're going to hear things that are going to be interesting and it might help you have a healthier lifestyle. And you'll learn a little bit more about that here in a few minutes and then next week as well. But I don't want to get to that yet. Little hazy out there, at least it was when we came in about a half hour ago. So if you're in the Mayville area right now, drive carefully if you go out. It's going to be melting off. It's going to be a great weekend. I think this is going to be the best weekend of the year, of 2015. Clear skies, and today and tomorrow are supposed to be absolutely perfect summer. So get out there and enjoy all the things that Chautauqua County offers to you. There's music, there's yard sales, there's entertainment, there's great foods and restaurants, there's the lakes. I mean, you name it, we've got it here, other than a desert. I think we got everything but that. It's just a great place to be hiking and fishing, boating. So I'm glad to be back, but I got to tell you, Europe was great, and we had a wonderful time. And I made a little note here that the trip consisted of riding 3 trains, 4 cab rides, 8 airplane rides, and I think we covered something like 16,000 miles. We were in southern Germany, and then we went over to the west Germany. We went to Paris, came back, went to the east Germany, over into the Bavaria, Austria area. Then we were up into north Germany, and then back down to the south, and it was just terrific. I know it was a little bit warm here, but over there we actually hit 100 degrees, I think, 3 days, and it was just wild. And everybody wants to know, well, what was your most memorable moment? My most memorable moment, it's hard to say, was when I was standing in the Louvre, just finished seeing the Mona Lisa, and my family lost me, or I lost them. I don't know. We still are debating who lost who, but I watched my daughter Stephanie wave and saying, "Dad, we're over here," and it was like watching a river of human kindness or humanness just flowing by me, and I never did find them for 2 hours later. And so it was quite a story, but if you ever have a chance to travel over to Europe, just a great place, and very welcoming everywhere we went. It was just a great time. Okay, let's first start off here that I have some notes that I want to thank my colleagues here at the station, Randy Burt and Jeff Zook, for carrying on for me as hosts. Sometimes I get tongue-tied, sometimes I get confused. This is not always as easy as it looks, and they really forged ahead and did a great job. Vicki Westling, thank you. She came in the second week and did a superb job with Vince Horgan and her guest. And a lot of times people don't realize that this is an all-volunteer organization here, and the guys get up every Saturday morning, they put in few hours here at the station, get everything lined up so we can provide some really good programming and information for you, and so that you get to know what's going on here in Chautauqua County and the nearby areas into Pennsylvania, up into Erie County and that. So thanks, folks, for helping me out while we were gone. Appreciate it. It's always nice to get away, and of course, as they always say, there's no place like home, and that's true. Okay, right off the bat, let's get into some announcements, and then I'll have a few other things to share with you. So let's see what we got here. This item we've been talking about for the last, couple months here, over at the Bemis Point Library. Let's pop that up. There's only 2 weeks left, folks. They have a study club raffle. And we got a picture of that, Jeff? $1 for one ticket or six for five, and the drawing will be held Labor Day weekend. I know there's a picture because I've seen it. It's a bicycle. Do we have that? Maybe not. All right. Anyways, if you happen to go, there it is. Wow, all right. Lovely bike. Only 2 weeks left. Get over to the Bemis Point Library. They appreciate it because everybody right now is trying to raise money the best they can. Okay, coming up September 12th. There it is. Now, I know it's hard to read, but somewhere in the middle on the right side of the screen is my name. The Infinity Visual Performing Arts is calling still for volunteers to help in the 12th Annual Local Music Showcase. The Local Showcase is an annual event hosted to raise much-needed funding for music and arts instruction at the Infinity Center. This fundraiser, which is held throughout downtown Jamestown, will be the place Saturday, September 12th. Over 50 local bands and musicians donate their time each year to help Infinity, and 13 local venues will donate their space for the cause. I'll tell you a little bit more when we get closer to this, but if you like local music and you like a variety of things, you can start out one place with maybe some folk music, end up going to some place for some jazz, and then cap the evening off with maybe some heavy metal, I don't know, whatever you like. But as you can see, oh, there it is. I'm going to be at the Phoenix Rising, what? Wellness studio, right. I know, you think I would know that, but these are one of those things that I don't look at until it gets closer to the event. But anyways, my buddies Ng and Davis are going to follow up behind me, and we've all shadowed each other over the years. And this is my fourth time helping out with this showcase, and it's a great time. It's $10, and you get a wristband to go all over to the city checking out all the venues. Great time. Okay, we have a new announcement coming up here, and this is the Rotary Club of Fredonia and Dunkirk. They're working together to have a blood screening program, and this will be held September 12th, Saturday, from 6:15 a.m. to 9:20 a.m. at the Fredonia High School. And the benefits from this go to the clubs, which in turn, as many of you know, goes right back into the communities. And this tests for all sorts of things, and I'm not going to go into all the details because I'm not the expert on this. But they test you for a variety of things, and there's different costs for different things. And if for more information, if you need, is 326-3917. Okay, so that's the Rotary Screening Program, the same day as the local music showcase. So you get your blood screened in the morning, and then come out and have a beer. Okay, in other information, we'll get to the photo here in a minute, but not yet. The Westfield Women of the Moose have just received an urgent appeal for school supplies and backpacks for children in our community. The ongoing need, coupled with the recent flooding, that was before I left, so that would have been back in July. I think there was 250 homes were flooded in Chautauqua County. Because of this, they've really impacted many local families. New and gently used backpacks are needed for all ages, and also various school supplies such as pencils, pens, crayons, tissues, glue sticks, etc. are needed for grades K through 12. The Women of the Moose will be collecting these items between now and September 1. They may be dropped off at the Moose Lodge on Clinton Street in Westfield, the Westfield Methodist Church, the Community Bank in Westfield, Key Bank, and Lakeshore Savings, all in Westfield. Monetary donations are also gratefully accepted. The women's of the Moose members will be using these funds to shop for additional school supplies that are needed for students. During the week of September 1st, the women will be compiling all the donations and deliver them to the Westfield Academy Central School to be distributed to students in need. Thanks for your support if you already have done so, and we encourage you to continue if you haven't. And other news, tonight, 21 Bricks, the Westfield Mayville Rotary Club will be having a social that's open to the general public. Tickets are $20, and yours truly will be entertaining. And, well, I'll be providing the entertainment. Whether I'll be entertaining is up to you. I've been there a few times. Great venue, and it's just a great location, and it's always a good time. That's from 7 to 9 tonight, so come on out. Also want to share with you, our sponsor, Jack's Barcelona Drive-In, is having music every Wednesday, and I'll be appearing next Wednesday and the following Wednesday from 6:30 to 8:30. And for my friends that I work with out at in Westfield for the Barcelona Blues Band, we're going to be performing September 4th at the, I believe, Market Street entrance there. They're going to block that off, I believe, and we're going to be performing there again. That's just a snippet of the music and the entertainment in the region here. You go to every community and there's music in the gazebos, music farmers markets, everywhere. This county is just awesome when it comes to live music and good things in the fine arts. Okay, I have a photograph that I wanted to share with you, and we can pop that up. Thanks, guys. Okay, now, you may or may not know who these people are, and if you do, I'll be amazed. This is the Kaspari family, and these are our friends in northern Germany. And the reason why I brought this picture in today, because the young lady in the blue and black striped blouse there is Julianne. And this young lady, when she was 15, 16 years old, had a dream to come to America. She had the American flag in her bedroom, and she just dreamt about coming here. She signed up for an organization to be an exchange student, and lo and behold, the Hamels family in Ripley, New York, was her host parents for a year. And because of this young lady is one of the reasons why my wife and I, and my daughter for that matter, and the rest of the kids, we travel to Europe and visit them quite often. We've been there a number of times over the years. Lovely family. Her dad, Rudolph, is a medical doctor right in the community of Mellendorf, and his lovely wife, Lioba, who is just phenomenal. A German mama takes care of all your needs. It's like going to a high-end hotel, and that she just waits on you, and it makes you almost crazy because you wanna just jump in and work with her and help prepare meals and things like that, but she'll always tell you, no, just sit down and relax, and just makes you comfortable. Her brother, Michael, in the middle with the glasses, is now a surgeon. And her brother, we call him Yosi, with the, I think it's light blue shirt there. He's a linguist, and he's just a phenomenally funny guy, and we just really enjoy our company. So the reason why I bring this up as well is if for those of you that in the community, if you ever have an opportunity to be a host family for Rotary or any of these other organizations, it's a great experience, and I've talked to I don't know how many families that have done this sort of thing, and it's a lifelong experience. And you just go back and back and back, back and forth with these families. And the Kaspari families have come to Ripley twice, and we look forward to them again. So anyways, I wanted to share that with you, that we have hands across the water, as the Beatles used to say, friendships that go back and forth. And this world isn't as big as you think it is. And the people in Europe worry about the things that we worry about here in America. And we're just really good friends with them. And we only wish them the best and hope to see them again soon. Okay, we're going to take a public service announcement break, and we'll be right back with a really terrific show coming right up in a minute. Stay tuned.
Hello, I'm Community Television.
And I'm Corporate Media. The channels I own serve as my personal mouthpiece. I tell you what I've told you you want to know.
Wow, that sounds really great for you. I carry local programming by local people and provide a forum for diverse community dialogues that anyone can participate in.
Really local, huh? Well, I own stations all over the country, so my programming is designed to be generic and appealing to the majority. It keeps my corporate advertisers happy.
I connect people to their communities by televising local government meetings and community events, things that would otherwise never be shown on TV.
Huh. Well, I could never do that. But hey, everything I show is carefully screened through focus groups gathered from NASCAR races and Walmart parking lots. I suppose you let just about anybody on TV.
That's right, we do. Community television makes production facilities and training available to every member of the community, who can then produce their own programming and have it televised free of charge.
Well, that sounds terribly unprofitable.
Oh, corporate media. It's not always about money.
Announcements, but that guy's got a terrific laugh. Makes me laugh. Okay, well, if you're just tuning in, I'm Doc Hamels. You're watching Chautauqua Sunrise, and we've got a great show right now, and we're going to be talking about massage therapy, and my guest today is someone that I've known over the years, Keri Nothum. Well, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
And Keri has graciously accepted the challenge to come on the show today and talk about an area that I don't know very much about. And I'll just kind of throw it out there right off the bat. Massage therapy or massage, when I was growing up, it was you always saw it in the James Bond movies where he went into this salon where this Oriental woman was doing something and he always had a gun under the bed or something like that. Or you always saw, somebody in Europe, some woman named Olga or somebody, throwing people around and twisting them and all that sort of thing.
Yeah, it's come a long way since then, and unfortunately, because of things like that James Bond image, it's made it a little bit more difficult to get that good therapeutic,
right.
or get the word out there that it is a good therapeutic service and not just something that people go in for other reasons. And, honestly, because of those things, mm-hmm. And because some of them still do exist, a lot of the states have licenses now that are very, very hard on ethical issues and something that we unfortunately have to go through and deal with. But yeah, to go with the Olga thing, I remember my very first experience massaging someone. It was a male client, and it was at school. It was at massage school,
sure.
And he's like, "I would like a female that provides deep pressure." And so my teacher had assigned me to him, and so I'm 18 years old. I can do this. I got this. And he looked at me up and down, and he's like, "I need somebody else." And I'm like, oh, "Can you just give me a chance?" I pleaded with him, and my heart broke. I've tried so hard. I can do this. And he did, and he was my client for the rest of the time. I was sweating and put all into it, but.
So there's sort of the stigma of what it is. But before we dispel all that, people don't know who you are necessarily. I know some of the people who are watching from Ripley and Westfield may know who you are. But tell us a little bit about yourself.
I grew up in Ripley. Okay. I have been a massage therapist for almost 15 years now.
Wow.
After graduating school, I went into Erie and took some a massage therapy course. It was about 9 months. Course, and then I've been really practicing ever since then. I have worked in chiropractic offices, worked in spa environments, and I have been teaching and was the head of a program in Erie for about 4 years, and just recently started, and I am heading a new program at Mercyhurst University.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Now, many people that may be watching right now, I don't know, I'm guessing they say, well, did you grow up dreaming to be a massage therapist? That's not one of the top 10 occupations, but it sounds really interesting. So how did you get interested?
The honest answer, I'll tell you that.
Long as we can say it on TV.
The honest answer is I wanted to do, I was in athletics, things like that,
sure.
And I wanted to work something, and typical answer from massage is, I want to help people. Well, mm-hmm. I wanted to help people, but I was really interested about the body and how it worked and stuff too. However, I didn't know if I wanted to commit myself to a 4-year commitment to college and just finances, all those different things.
Sure.
So this came about, and I don't even remember who had suggested it. And I'm like, you know what? If nothing else, I am going to learn a trade. Mm-hmm. If I do nothing with it, if I don't make money, if I don't do anything else but know that, hey, when my friend's back's hurt, or I can do something about it. Mm-hmm. All I need is my hands, and I'll be able to do that. And so it's kind of taken off for me from there.
Wow, well, that's terrific. You said something very important, and it's near and dear to my heart, because I was involved with the vocational and technical education, career tech, you name the words, with both these for a million years. And I know that a lot of people firmly believe that, to make it in life, you got to go to a four-year college and stuff. That's just not true.
Right.
And I've challenged people this for 35 years or more on that fact. It's just not true. You can get a wonderful lifestyle with a two-year certificate or 18-month program or whatever, and, mm-hmm. and you're another example. My daughter is another. My son's another. Right. All my kids, they've done very well for themselves, but you always need that one more step beyond high school, and that's really great. So where'd you get your training?
I went to Great Lakes Institute of Technology in Erie.
Okay.
Yep, I went there. I had visited a few other places that I kind of wanted to go. There's in New York, like Finger Lakes School of Massage. It's in Ithaca, which mm-hmm. if you've ever been to Ithaca, it was really nice. It's where Cornell and everything
right,
is.
Right, I've been
and
there, yeah.
This is really fun, but my parents wanted me to stay a little bit closer, right. So that's what
But you're fortunate that they had a facility that close by, so that's great.
Yep, definitely.
Okay, you said something that kind of rang a bell just now, and you said, I wanted to take away pain from my friends if they were hurting. What do you mean by that?
Well, you hear people saying that their back hurts all the time.
That'd be right here?
Right? Yeah, all the time. And especially when you tell them you're a massage therapist.
Yeah.
It comes out of the woodwork. Well, my back hurts, or this happens.
What do you do for this?
Or I'm getting this kind of pain, or you always get something. And when I was 18, was I aware that that was an issue? No, but I knew people that suffered, from muscular aches.
It happens when you're 19 on up.
Right?
When you get out of high school.
Right. So it was just... And again, my mindset at that point was more athletics and things. And mm-hmm. of course, I'd felt the soreness of working out and stuff even at that age.
Now, you were a softball player, were you?
Yep.
I remember that.
And,
yeah.
And volleyball and mm-hmm. anything else I could get myself into.
Sure.
But you learn that people have muscular aches, and you just know somebody can always benefit from it.
Mm-hmm.
And not knowing then, but knowing more now, is... just that positive touch for some people is what they need more than just to help fix their back.
Positive
no
touch,
fix.
What do you mean by that?
Positive touch. I'm going to get into my feelings of it, but
that's fine.
I feel like our culture and our society has not necessarily accepted positive touch, or we have like this barrier because unfortunately
Absolutely.
There are people and things out there that
don't touch
are scary.
Me, don't hug me.
Yeah,
I don't do this.
This is not something that I want. And you get into people. One of the first things I've done as a teacher is I have people go out and count how many times or how many people they've touched throughout that day. So you get the moms. And moms get touched a million times because
sure.
they're all over the place. The kids are
yeah,
on top of
yeah.
them. And but then for our male clientele, it's a lot different.
Mm-hmm.
Even as a father, you don't necessarily get touched as much as a mother.
Unless you're in my house, because it's usually it's my crew.
Right. But there's all, there's that dynamic. And
Absolutely.
It's great when it is. Or if you're a single person that goes home, has your own place, like to count how many times you get touched is easy. Some people come in, maybe they got held a door open for someone and accidentally touched something, but that positive touch isn't necessarily something we get all the time. And touch is something that I personally feel that our body needs to thrive since being born.
It's so funny that you said that, because I'm sitting here and I'm and this is just recent. I was sitting talking with my friends in Europe, mm-hmm. and I don't know, a couple times one of them just reached out and touched me on the hand. And it wasn't anything other than trying to make a point
sure.
or whatever, but there was a connection there. It was almost like a little electricity. And I don't want to say it was uncomfortable, but it was something that we just don't do a lot of, unless you're family or something like that, or
right.
you're really good buddies. And then there's people that that do touch us, and it makes us sometimes uncomfortable because we have these barriers in that.
Right. Like we've grown up. Yeah, and it all depends on the family, too. Like
right.
you said, in your family, you get touched all the time,
oh
and the kids
God.
Are climbing all over
Leave
you.
Leave me alone.
Yeah, come on.
Four kids and a dog, yeah. and my wife yelling.
So And as grandparents, you know, things like right. that brings another element of, mm-hmm. of touched into your life. But it is something that we stray away from. And I know that some clients will come to see me or have come to see me in the past because that's the positive touch that they get in their life. So, yeah, I'm sure they have some back pain, but that might not be the root of why they're coming, especially when we get into like a geriatric population. You know, we've done a lot of good work at senior centers, things like that, mm-hmm. Where families don't come to visit or whatever, and you're just giving them that good positive touch.
You know, when I wrote down geriatrics, and I have a whole list of other things here that I wrote down as we getting ready for the show today, but that's interesting about touch, because when you think about it, let's say someone was married for a long, long time and they've lost their spouse, mm-hmm. and they live alone.
Right.
When was the last time they were touched?
Right.
And yet when you go up and give them a hug, the hug is just, they melt into you, and it's like so good. Mm-hmm. So this is therapeutic, just the fact that you're doing massage and touch.
Right.
And, you know, you can feel people when they're upset. You just put your mm-hmm. hand on their shoulder, they melt. So right. tell me more about what do you do for the body than what massage?
What I do for the body as far as like a physiological thing
yeah.
or more than
yeah, sure, whatever.
Well, it can have, when you're touching, it comes to, I'm trying to think of how I want to go with it. When it comes to physically being able to help somebody, so say you have muscle tension or soreness, knots, you know, in your back, and maybe you're getting a headache or whatever result that you may have from it. Massage can help increase blood flow. It brings blood to the area, and when our body gets blood means healing, right?
Oh,
for
sure.
the most time,
sure.
or defending. So mm-hmm. we have an inflammation, and so we'll get that blood there, and it's all red, and maybe is warm to the touch. Massage can help that by bringing new blood in there and flushing the old blood out. We also work a lot with the fascia of the body, which the fascia is one of my favorite things to talk about. But fascia is what encases our body as a whole and what different muscles are encased by individually. So sometimes think of it like I don't know how to describe it well. That's why I have the oranges that come into play. But it's kind of like a spider web in our body, okay? Right. So this spider web, this thin layer, encases our body as a whole. So
okay.
if people eat like a chicken breast or something like that, or, you know, Chautauqua County, if we have some hunters and things like that, like when you take the first layer of skin off, mm-hmm. you have this thin like silver lining.
Okay.
That's our fascia.
Okay.
And a lot of times, because our fascia rubs on top of each other, mm-hmm. okay, because it's encased as a whole and then individually, it will have adhesions or knots, you know, that you feel. So sometimes it's not necessarily the muscle, it's because that fascia has become stagnant and it can't go, you know, it can't slide again along each other as well.
Use the term knots, and people always say, I got a knot in my neck.
Right.
Are these really, I mean, what is it? I know you said it was this fascia, but is it truly like a little clump of something, or is it just the feeling that's there?
It's the feeling that's there. Okay. It feels like a knot. It can be muscle or fascia or kind of both. But it just feels like a knot. Nothing's really knotted up. It's just, mm-hmm. it's not
like
able to
tightness.
Move as well. It
yeah.
tightens.
Mm-hmm.
And the way I describe it, you know, two people to be able to get it out or talking to the students is, of course, we know we have muscle fibers that go in all kinds mm-hmm. of different directions, right? If you have like a little spool of thread that's in a knot, then you're just going to rub it between your fingers mm-hmm. and just wait for it to loosen up. And hardly ever, you're not going to pull one string and it's going to fade away and be perfect. Same kind of thing with those adhesions. You're just going to kind of work at it as much as you can and get it as loosened up as
you're
you possibly can.
You're not passionate about this, are you?
Yeah, a little bit.
It's coming
through
loud. I told
you I could talk forever.
Well, this is wonderful, because that's what makes shows like this so great is when people bring passion. But hold one second, folks. You're watching Chautauqua Sunrise. My guest today is Keri Nothum, who is a licensed massage therapist. And I have neglected to tell you that you can call us at 753-5225. You can Twitter us, tweet us. You can email us. You can walk in, ask a question. But if you have a question for Keri, or you have an announcement that you want to announce besides what we're talking about today, give us a call. We're here and happy to hear from you, okay? So, back to you. Now, we're talking about the body, we're talking about touch, we're talking about knots in our bodies and things like that, and you said you use your hands, okay? So, how does one know how to use their hands? I mean, obviously there's ways you're going to hurt somebody and there's ways that you're going to use it correctly. So tell me about how you know how to do all this.
Well, I mean, obviously from just training and learning, the more people you touch, the more intuitive and you know, that your touch is going to be with different kinds of different mm-hmm. bodies, different people. Okay. So you just learn how, you learn the anatomy of the body first. You know, you start by learning how things work. And then you learn from there what how to approach it and what to.
So there's a lot of science to this.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So this isn't just like, you know, I'm going to go check this out, you know. I mean, this is serious stuff, right?
Sure, yep.
Okay. We got a phone call already.
Oh,
you ready? Good morning, caller.
Good morning. I got to thinking that for folks who have to go through quite a bit of physical therapy, and that can be quite painful, I think that massage therapy is great to go in there and help you relax so you're able to do a better job with your physical therapy and what you do in follow-up. I'm also wondering, is there a way that massage therapy can help keep scar tissue from forming where you've had injuries?
Okay, awesome question. I don't know.
Yeah, that is a really great question, and it can. What it can do is, again, that fascia I was talking mm-hmm. about, when you have an injury, it builds itself up. So taking and massaging against the grain, if you will, or against the fiber,
sure.
to help reduce that gently, you know, it has to be so much time after injury to make sure that it's not painful or anything, but it can definitely help reduce scar tissue. And there are some, you know, research that shows that it actually can help with scar tissue reduction. So.
Wow. Anything else, caller?
No, thank you. You've been very informative, and I'm enjoying the show very much.
And we're just getting started. Well, thanks for calling, and if you have any other follow-up questions, give us a call.
Okay, thanks.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
See how easy that was, folks? Just give us a call, and Keri's here to answer all your questions. Okay, and let's talk about that. She says for physical therapy. Do you work with physical therapists?
For physical therapy, they get training in massage also.
Oh,
so
mm-hmm.
maybe not to the degree that,
sure.
that we do, but they perform some. Of course, their objective is going to be a little bit different than ours. Their scope of practice is broader than what ours is. But I think that massage is a good couple, you know, with physical therapy and like chiropractic work or whatever, just being able to go in, loosen up those muscles, relax before. Because physical therapy, if anybody's had it, it can be
pretty intense.
I mean, that's their objective, mm-hmm. is to get you out there and get you moving again.
Mm-hmm.
So getting a massage to complement that is always nice.
Well, thank you, caller, for bringing that up. We may not have even touched on that topic, so that's great. You mentioned chiropractors work with massage therapists. Okay, so let me see if I get this straight. Physical therapist is one area, and they're helping people to recoup, stretch body muscles to do everyday life skills. There's massage therapy, and we'll get back to that here in a second. And then we have the bone doctors, as I call them, the chiropractors that are doing adjustments and things like that. So where does massage therapy come into that area?
Into chiropractic work. Well, like you said, the bone doctors are focused on structure.
Okay.
So that skeletal system and the structure of the body, dealing with nerves, you know, things like that that's branched from that structure. Massage, we deal with the soft tissue, we deal with those muscles. So if, think about a tight rubber band,
mm-hmm.
right? If it pulls out of place and it's still tight here, you can put that structure back into place, but it's still gonna pull it back out. Whereas if we release and we relax this soft tissue, this rubber band, you know, loosen it up, bring that good blood flow, all those things, then that structure will go back into place easier and for a longer period of time.
Okay, so let me give you an example of what I'm thinking of. Not of recent days, because maybe I'm either moving slower and I'm not messing around with my back as much, but the term we throw our back out,
mm-hmm.
okay, and which is really something slipping, maybe it's a disc or something
right,
back
yeah,
there
something.
Structurally,
mm-hmm.
and they're always telling you to do this stretching and this sort of thing to do what I think you just said, is keep the blood going, but it's so. A massage therapist could really help somebody with back.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, a lot with that back pain. And like you said, they're telling you to stretch because they want you to lengthen and loosen that muscle because they're looking for a long-term objective. They're looking for a long-term goal. You know, so that's your homework, right? As you go home stretch, sure. They give you things to do. Foam rolling's really in, you know, mm-hmm. These days where they send you home foam roll and whatever. Even though you should still be doing that, and some massage therapists that you go to will give you those similar suggestions also. Massage is a good complement to that.
Okay, so if I can just digress just a little bit deeper into this. Mm-hmm. So you're dealing with the soft tissue, and you said deep tissue, and I don't know what the opposite is, not deep tissue, but mm-hmm. what's the differences between all that?
Different types of massage. Now, deep tissue and what they call like Swedish or relaxation, mm-hmm. you know, massage. It's always been this like battle, what's the difference between the two? A lot of people feel like deep tissue going in and maybe your back really hurts and you like a heavier touch. So you're going to go in and maybe book a deep tissue massage.
So Olga comes in.
Olga comes in, she throws an elbow down on you, and you're fixed, and everything is good. So that's not necessarily that. Some people just enjoy a heavier touch. Mm-hmm. You know, some people want to feel that manipulation, you know, of that soft tissue.
People are sensitive at different levels, I suppose,
exactly.
Right?
And so that's a good point. So some people may want that deeper, heavier touch in their back, but more of a lighter touch on their legs because they can be more sensitive. So that's when the therapist really needs to listen to you, look for body cues. You know, one thing we always look for is like the clenching of the fists because mm-hmm. people don't realize they do that when
usually
they're trying to relax.
If you see me crying, that's usually stopping.
Well, your face is down in that little thing, so we don't necessarily see that.
That feels really good.
Yeah. So the difference, so that's a heavy touch, and that's most of the time what people will want. If mm-hmm. someone comes in for a massage for the very first time, I won't refuse to give them a deep tissue, but
they don't know what they're asking for,
right,
maybe.
I try and educate them and say, I can give you a heavier touch without that deep tissue. Deep tissue is going to be specific more for chronic pain for a specific ailment. So you threw your back out.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so maybe you want me to work specifically, do certain techniques and certain work that muscle and that muscle group a certain way. That's going to be more specific deep tissue. I'm going into deeper levels of the muscle, not giving heavier pressure.
I would say that many of my viewers are probably closer to my age, and whether we like to say it or not, arthritis, mm-hmm. rheumatism, things like this come into play into our lives. Because we've been working our joints and our muscles and body limbs at work and heavy, right? Heavy work and heavy play. So how about that? How about arthritis, you know?
It can definitely help with arthritis because that's the inflammation of, you know, those joints, things like
okay.
that. It can help relieve. It's not going to be able to take it away, mm-hmm. you know, obviously. But it can definitely help relieve some of that pain and stuff you get from arthritis to help calm down the guarding that your muscles are doing mm-hmm. as a result of that.
So with arthritis, this is, you said it doesn't go away. So probably will a doctor, a medical doctor, recommend massage therapy?
They might. I mean, they're probably going to recommend, they're probably going to have you on like
medications,
anti-inflammatory or something, you know, something like that to help take that away. But depending on where it is, they may have you, you know, get a massage, especially if it's spine, hips, things like that. That, like I said, your body's going to guard your muscles, because that's what our bodies, you know, are mm-hmm. meant to do. We're supposed to protect, so they can help relax those muscles around it.
So massage therapy, is it long-term lasting, or is it helping you on the road to recovery, or is it all above? I guess it's everything, right?
Yeah, it's a case by case, really. It mm-hmm. just depends on the individual and the objective that they want to have with it. Some people will strictly just go get a massage because that's their hour in time that they get to relax and not have to chase after kids. And so their objective is relaxation. And if that's what they want, and they want that part of their, you know, we talked about wellness, healthy, mm-hmm. lifestyle.
Yeah.
If that's what they want is, you know what, I'm taking an hour for myself and, you know, once a month, once a week, whatever, and that's my time for me. That objective is going to be consistent. So is massaging helping in that moment? Sure, but it's going to continue to help the more they come.
Okay, cumulative effect.
Yes.
Kind of thing. Can you overdo it?
It depends on the ailment. Yeah, I wouldn't say that someone needs a massage every single day.
Mm-hmm.
Could people use one? Sure, but when we talk about massage, duration and frequency kind of go together.
Okay.
So if you come in, we'll say once a month to get a massage, then and you're a hard worker, you're, you know, I don't know, you're and laying down cement or building houses. Right, you know what I mean? And I'm not, you know, some of my... I will say, side note, that a lot of my more difficult clients that have a lot of pain are people that are in front of the computers because their bodies are like they're hunched over.
Right here in the neck area.
Everything's coming, you know, coming forward. But if you're someone that this is what your life is, you can't change that. You know, ergonomically, you're not going to be able to pick up that bag or those shingles any better than what you already are. You can come in once a month. Then probably a 90-minute massage is what's going to be good for you.
Oh,
you know,
tune you up kind of
you're
thing.
Right. Yeah. But if you come in once a week, then you know, half hour, hour is going to be good too. So you consider that when.
So the body tells you, you know, what's going on. I'm sitting here thinking about some of my viewers might be having a baby, and I always remember my wife just saying, "Oh my God, if there's anything that I that is the tough thing is that her back and legs would just kill her."
Yeah.
What do you do for folks like that?
You can get a prenatal massage. Mm-hmm. You know, most of the spas will offer or have somebody that that gives a prenatal massage, and most schools will teach, you know, introductory to that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's just a different kind of massage. You learn, like, you know, obviously we can't treat a pregnancy the same as we would a typical massage. Right. They're actually under a special needs, you know, category, especially if they've ever had any complications or anything in the past. So there's different ways that you learn how to work on the client, you know, the pregnancy. You have to ask a lot of questions about how their pregnancy has been. But there's a lot of benefit. You know, you learn techniques that will help relax the muscles, that will help.
I can well imagine. I mean, when you think about the woman's body and the joints and the bones are spreading every which way and the muscles are going with it and the nerves. Yeah. So that's great. Question about this one. Because my daughter, as you know, is involved with her salon over in Northeast, and they're one of our underwriters here at the show, Bella Spa and Salon, I know there's something called detoxes. Mm-hmm. What is a massage therapist? they wrap you up with seaweed? I don't know what they do with you. What's that all about?
Yeah, the detox.
I haven't done this yet.
I have done it. Actually, I've never experienced it, but I have. I have never experienced it, but I have given them. The idea behind a detox is to help draw toxins out of your body. Now, toxins can be from stress. It can be from drinking too much caffeine. We get toxins everywhere, you know, from everything. And so the idea is that there's a solution that you wrap, you know, and it will help draw it out.
Well, now wait a minute. You got to explain more of this. How you're wrapping them in what now?
Well, it all depends on.
Just give us an example.
Okay,
an example.
you can put the solution on, and you can wrap whether it's a cloth. So you soak the solution in a cloth and like mummy wrap it, you know, around.
Mummy, like an Egyptian mummy.
Yes, okay. An Egyptian mummy. Wrap it around, or you can take a. Even like a saran wrap and kind of wrap that around the body. The idea is for the solution to naturally absorb into your body.
Now, isn't this just a little freaky for people to be wrapped up like a mummy? How long does this last? I mean, I know claustrophobic people, not me, I'm okay with it, but I would know some people would say, this is really uncomfortable here.
Well, yeah, but they know when they're signing up for it. Okay. You know, as a therapist, they go into the room and be like, this is what I'm doing, are you going to be okay with this?
Okay, and this is where I say, don't try this at home, kids.
Yeah, it does show, you know, results, but I'm a big advocate for drinking a lot of water.
Okay.
And not that you can't get more direct, you will get direct results for the most part, some not as much as you'd want. But if you're a person that drinks as much water as you should every day.
Which is?
Well, it's opinion by different people, but everybody's body is different. So obviously someone, you know, my body type and your body type are going to probably need a different amount of water. So the basic is what they say, like 8 glasses a day.
Right.
What I've been told is that you take your body weight, divide it by half, and then drink that many ounces.
Holy moly.
In a day.
I'm not going to tell you how many gallons I got to drink. I got a question that just popped up here. It says, what advice would you have for young people just people in general that were interested in going to school for massage therapy?
What advice? I mean, I guess I'd just say go do it. You know,
probably visit with a therapist like yourself.
Yeah, go shadow, see what it's like. Google it. Google the different modalities and the different requirements each state requires. Just kind of think about what you want to do, the kind of population. If you Google massage modalities, and if you're communicating through that, hopefully it's right in front of you, you'll see a plethora of opportunities. So going to school would be your core, and then you just really have the opportunity to branch out to wherever you'd want to. Equine massage, canine massage. Like, there's so many different things you can get into.
Did you say horse and dog massage?
Yeah, yep. Yeah, and there's a...
Max, what do you think? Max would love it.
They're the best clients.
He just rolls on his back. He's like, do it.
Yeah,
now.
My tummy. It's awesome. Yeah.
I'm the dog massage therapist. too cool. Yeah. But this is an occupation that you have to be comfortable touching others.
Yes.
And that must take a little time.
It does to a certain point, I guess. Like I said, when I got into it, I'm 18. I'm like, all right, let's. And the most uncomfortable thing for me was having people touch me.
Mm-hmm.
And not that I didn't, enjoy the therapeutic benefits of it and, the relaxation of it. But, I'm 18, from little town of Ripley, and I'm like, okay, I'm ready to go.
James Bond is in his skivvies or less, right? I mean, so you got a towel over you, and that takes a little.
It does, and it is nice because in the 15 years I've been doing this, massage therapy has come a long way with requirements. And like I said, we talked about ethics for a second there. Right. That draping is very important. Okay. So making sure that
this is a very professional
occupation. And that's what we do, literally fight against all the time, is because people will, I don't know if people necessarily, when I meet them, think that, when I say I'm a massage therapist, but you always get this sly remark or something like that.
Yeah. And it's had a bad rap.
Yeah. And it's like, and again, telling my students, like, just educate people. Just
there
tell them. Like,
that's why you're here today.
I'm a massage therapist. This is what I do.
Mm-hmm. Chocolaca, moda, coffee, Swedish, throw in a vanilla whipped cream massage. I mean, you see all these crazy things on the lineups. Am I going for a massage or am I going for, dessert? I mean,
well, you can have both.
I mean, they have these flavored and scented things. I mean, is that just like just something that's sort of commercial out there, or what is the deal?
It is. I mean, some have benefits, like anything that has a coffee in it. Coffee is a diuretic, right? So the idea behind coffee is to help draw water out of the body, which goes against what I just said.
You're going to lotion up a person in coffee beans?
Well, no. You take the coffee grounds, actually, before you use them, or after you use them. I don't know, Google it. Google's the best thing ever. But sometimes, don't Google it.
Don't believe everything you see on Google.
Don't believe everything you see on Google. But, a lot of it is just, it sounds nice. You go in for Valentine's Day and you get this chocolate-covered strawberry wrap, and a lot of the spas, will, if they're thinking about the whole picture, will give you a chocolate-covered strawberry to go with it's just
it's kind of a package deal. But from a therapeutic point of view, it doesn't make a difference if it's chocolate or vanilla?
It does not make a difference. It's, when it comes down to it, if you're enjoying yourself, you're getting a therapeutic benefit
from it. All right,
now,
let's go along with the lotions we were talking about. So I'm assuming that sometimes you use certain types of oils or lotions to loosen up the muscles, things like that. That's part of it too, right?
Yes. There are different, you can get into aromatherapy, so there's different benefits using different scents.
Is this something you do?
The aromatherapy, I do, with aromatherapy. It's more a preference for the person. So lavender is a famous example of something that's relaxing, and it's good for burns and things like that. So the scar tissue, for example, that if someone came in and they wanted part of the massage to be specific for scar tissue, I might use a little bit of lavender with a vitamin E or something that, and kind of work on that towards the end of the massage.
Okay. Young children, can you do something for them too? I mean, is there an age limit? I mean, babies or?
No, I mean, from womb to, forever. It's really good for children. Mm-hmm. You think about when a baby first enters the world, they're used to having this all over encompassing sensation of
warmth
and touch and sensory, all that, those things, and then they're here and we swaddle them or whatever, but giving a good massage on all over, not, you know, this little tickly thing, but a, you know, infant massage is going to be like more of a kind of a gentle squeeze, and that those compression movements to children that have, you know, disabilities and things like that.
Sure.
You know, autism is a very large diagnosis these days. I have a six-year-old daughter who's autistic, and I have found, and I don't know, obviously, because when she was born, I didn't know.
Who knew?
But I've been giving her massages ever since she was born, and she doesn't have any sensory issues. She loves to be touched.
Very unusual for autistic children, too.
She'll give you a hug. She goes up to everybody, and she hugs because, you know, that's who she is. Do I have anything to put that against? No, but I, of course, feel like maybe that had something to do with it. So.
Okay. Weight loss.
Weight loss with massage.
Does that have any help for folks that are trying to lose weight?
I can't answer that. I don't really know. I think that the benefit I could see towards weight loss would be just being aware of your body. Having more body awareness and feeling better about yourself through getting the massage, having that relaxing time, and then just wanting to follow through.
Okay, great. We have another phone call, right?
All right, yeah.
Good morning, caller.
Well, good morning, Keri. Good morning, Doc. This is Linda Spaulding.
Linda, did you miss me? I've been gone.
yes, but we had a very good show last week on history.
That's Devin Taylor was here.
Oh,
he is.
Yeah.
I was watching him in Germany.
How was it in Germany?
It was awesome. It was great.
Yeah.
So what's up?
Well, I have a question.
Okay.
Does health insurance cover massage therapy?
Does insurance cover? Well, not most. Insurance can sometimes be paired and billed in certain services. So we were talking about chiropractic work. Mm-hmm. So sometimes there's so many units, and I'm not a billing person, so if I'm saying this wrong, I apologize. But there's so many units you can get of a massage at through a chiropractor or through and like physical therapy or whatever. Now, if people have like a flex spending thing, there's some places where they'll accept your insurance.
And there's more and more of those things, those flex spending, they'll cover that.
Yeah, there's more and more massage places. And I would just, you know, ask. Some massage therapists will cover like auto accidents. They have they have some connections. So I don't know if your insurance provider will be able to tell you, but you could always just call around and ask, you know, massage therapist. And for the most part, I mean, I think that we're a pretty good team, that if I knew somebody that accepted a certain insurance, I'd be like, no, but so-and-so does. Oh, give them a call.
Yeah. Okay. Good question, though.
Well, some insurance companies will pay for people to go to a fitness center, you know, so that you'll stay healthy.
Sure,
There are some companies that do that. And also, I do know that physical therapists do perform massage therapy themselves.
Right.
So, you know, it seems to be very closely related to the physical therapy and recovery.
Yes, they are. And it's funny, if you get into like a little bit of the history of massage, and off the top of my head, I can't specifically name the gentleman that was part of it, but massage and physical therapy kind of started off with the same person and then branched into different places. Mm-hmm. Obviously, physical therapy got a lot more, you know, medically, you know, with all their specialties, and their scope is a lot more detailed. But if insurance is if you need insurance to cover it, you can get it. You just have to kind of call around and research a little bit more.
Mm-hmm. It depends upon the company, I'm sure.
Right. Yeah. Right.
Okay, well, thank you very much. Also, I'd like to mention that there are services with the Chautauqua County Office for the Aging, and we have our senior employment program and our computer training. And my dogs are they're asking for massage therapy.
They heard canine massage.
Yeah. They'd like their jaws massaged. A dog is going by. So.
You've got them all wound up, Linda.
Well, have a great day and a great weekend. Thank you a lot.
Oh, my God. I have an earpiece, and you can't believe they're both chattering in my earpiece here. Okay. before we get to the oranges, we got to do something about these oranges you brought.
The
question is, and I think it was a follow-up, was a doctor can recommend for massage therapy, right, as a specialization?
Yes, and you just have to find a therapist, and usually that doctor would probably know a therapist that they would refer to.
Okay.
But yeah, they can.
That was a Twitter question that just popped up. So you brought some oranges. We have 4 minutes and 11 seconds, 10 seconds, 9 seconds left. So I'm intrigued by these things.
Okay, so you get an orange, and I have napkins here.
Oh my God. This could be the first time on my show here. All right,
here.
So what are we going to do with this thing?
Okay, so I talked about fascia, right?
Right, fascia.
And it encompasses the whole body.
Everything.
So when you get a massage.
Yes.
So this is our skin, which is the orange skin.
Orange skin.
A massage, we kind of try and loosen it up. So
anybody
that eats oranges, right, which I'm not a big fruit eater, but if you roll it a little bit.
All right, roll it.
Okay, it's going to kind of bring the juices, the blood, to the surface, right? Kind of getting it warmed up. So it's going to make it easier to peel.
Okay.
Right? So we peel our orange.
Peel the orange.
Peel the orange.
Okay.
Close up of me trying to get this orange in.
You're doing better than I am.
Maybe you need to roll it more.
Oh, I see the fascia.
Yes, you do see the fascia.
It's the thinner part.
Yeah. So mine's all juicy, making a mess, that's going to be an example of our blood, the good blood flow that happened. It's okay, I've had more experience than you at this.
This is the first time I've done this on TV before. I've never peeled an orange before on TV. I've done a lot of other things, but I haven't done this before. Okay. Okay. Wow, you're done.
I'm done.
Go ahead.
So, you know, we have this white membrane, right, that encompasses the whole orange.
The
fascia. That's going to be like the fascia of our body that encompasses everything. So then we have, if we pull the orange apart, which I'm sure everybody has done, we have these sections that they go into. So then these are going to be our muscles, our muscle groups. So we can pull this apart, so it's away from the body as a whole, right?
Right.
But we still have to have some juice, right? And right now, this doesn't move because it's stuck.
Okay.
If we rolled it more, got more juice in there, then it'd kind of be all mushy, which that's not necessarily how our body works. So then after we have these separate sections, we go even further. And
this is a science lesson, everybody.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is the best way. I rattled my brain. How can I explain this?
Mr. O'Brien would be proud of you.
And then you have these individual, it's still encased, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So these would be our muscle fibers.
Okay.
Okay, so body, muscle.
Right.
Muscle fibers.
Okay.
So that's a really good way to describe fascia. And the juicier.
I'm still working on my fascia here. Okay, I'm almost there. Okay, go ahead.
The more, it's making a mess, which again, if you've ever eaten an orange, it's going to make a mess when you get into it. But that's what helps, that can be considered our blood or that lubrication that we need to be able to move effectively.
It's all relative. I get it. Okay.
That's my
And
orange.
So what you're doing is when they're the in the fibers, it gets knotted up there, you're working it to get the juices moving and all that stuff.
Yeah, get that good blood flow in there.
Keri Nothum's been my guest today, folks, and we've got less than a minute left. And I'm going to put you on the spot. I'm going to ask you just to tick off every good reason why you should have massage therapy.
Every good reason. Just a typical response is it feels good, whether it helps with pain or injury, or you just get to relax.
If people want to get a hold of you for more information, do you have a phone number?
I do. You can get a hold of me. It's going to be area code 814-392-1180.
1180.
Yeah.
Okay. Keri, thanks for coming on the show and your demonstration of the fascia of a body. And folks, I hope you've enjoyed our show today on massage therapy. Check it out. A lot of places have this, especially Bella Salon, one of our underwriters here. So have a great weekend. It's great weather out there. We'll see you again next week on another good thing for your health. Stay tuned. I'm Doc Hamels. Take care. Bye-bye.